My name is Irving. I'm a solutions engineer at DJI Enterprise. Today, I will walk you through the essentials of dock-related regulation in Europe. DJI Dock 2, as our latest drone technology, helps organizations to perform remote missions efficiently and reliably. If you are interested in integrating DJI Dock 2 into your drone fleet, but don't know how to be compliant with legislation, then this video is for you. Today, we are going to cover three major topics. First, European regulation brief. Second, what is SORA? Third, documentation support from DJI. So let's get started. Typical drone operations usually involve a pilot and a drone. Under the European Aviation Safety Agency regulation, depending on the perceived risk of those operations, they can be categorized into either open category or specific category. So, if you remotely operate the Matrice 3D without an on-site pilot, which is a common use for Dock 2, it will be considered as beyond visual line of sight operation and will fall under specific category. To operate in specific category under non-standard scenario, you will need to secure an operational authorization from your national aviation authority. There are two methods to achieve it. PDRA, Predefined Risk Assessment, or SORA, Specific Operation Risk Assessment. Considering of operational flexibility, documentation volume, and other factors, we have seen that SORA is a preferred path for most dock users. So, what is SORA? SORA is a comprehensive methodology to measure and reduce operational risk. This methodology consists in 10 steps. Today, we will talk about four key points. Ground risk class determination, air risk class determination, cell determination, and operational safety objectives. Ground risk class refers to the process of evaluating and mitigating the risk that the drone operation might have on doing damage to the ground. Similarly, air risk class evaluates the conditions to prevent the drone from flying into demanded aircraft airspace and avoid other obstacles in the air. Once we have completed the GRC and ARC, we can determine CEL, which stands for Specific Assurance Integrity Level. It's a combination of ground risk and air risk after mitigation has been implemented. Then, in order to ensure the operation is as safe as possible, we must follow the operational safety objectives requirements. OSO could be roughly divided into technical UAV-related parts and organizational operator-related parts. Regarding the technical UAV-related part, to help dock operator to fly safer and get approval more smoothly, DJI provides essential documentations to facilitate the SORA process, including technical information for operations manual, SORA template, and compliance of requirements, functional hazard assessment report, manufacturer declaration as basic containment for SORA, and so on. Click the link in the description below the video. After completing a quick survey, you can download the supporting documents. Feel free to contact the DJI dealers in your country for more legislation guidance. In past few months, there are several success SORA cases with Dock 2 happened in Europe. One example comes from the Czech Republic, where our partner Tallink demonstrated the feasibility of obtaining BVLOS permission with a cell 2 of SORA in an open pit mining scenario. Tallink team was able to secure the permissions within 2 months. This is just one example showing it's a viable option for users. And we are seeing many successful cases upcoming across Europe. As the drone industry evolves, DJI continues to innovate, ensuring product compliance and safety. The legislature is also optimizing the regulations to balance the technological innovation and safety standards. I hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a comment below about what topics we should cover next time. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and follow DJI Enterprise official channel to stay updated with latest drone trends.